is up, you radical guys and gals out there? It's me, Raku95, here with the newest installation of my Halo 5 Map Showcase series, MapQuest, the show where I, Raku95, give you, the viewers, a tour of maps fresh out of the works. Today, we'll be looking at a mostly faithful old remake, straight out of Bayonetta 2, specifically of Noatun. City of Genesis. I believe that's how it's pronounced. I don't know, it's honestly been a long time ever since I touched my only working copy for Bayonetta 2 that I have on my Wii U, or at least had. Okay, real quick story. How it went from have to had. Well, you can honestly thank my brother for fucking raging as much as he did it at fucking Melee. Hey. Apparently lost one too many games that actually drove him to that point of fucking doing his impression of Captain Falcon's Falcon Punch on the goddamn TV. If I remember correctly as to his motive for doing so, I think it was... That's because he kept losing at one event, the final event, where it's like you have to beat both Master and Crazy Hand at the same time. Fuck, who knew? Who the casual peasants could be so fucking triggered over something so fucking stupid? Not that at us competitive master race is get triggered over our own stupid shit. Like being forced by casual peasants to do their bidding. Like, I have no business disassociating with you worthless insects. But let the casuals be fucking casual peasants. Anyways, ripping on casual peasant, since like the competitive master race that I am, aside, let's actually get to the thing who likely dropped in on this video for. Me actually showcasing the map, and not rambling on about how competitive is much more, or fucking, you know. Anyway, when you spawn on blue team, there's one of two locations here in this port that you can spawn. And regardless, each side of the port houses a spawn for a standard battle rifle and two frags. Hex. Standard for all my maps. Now, as you keep running along both ends of the port, you will eventually you converge to the middle, or to the staircase that leads up to the plaza, or to the bridge that leads to the plaza of Noatun. From here, if you don't got a good gun already, there's a conveniently placed SMG that lies at the bottom of the stairs. There is that lead up and into the plaza of Noatun. But wait. If you have a good enough eye, you probably caught something with it. In these little streams here on either side. Turns out each one is its own respective spawn for a splinter grenade. And it makes for some pretty good impromptu cover. Or if you're getting shot at from maybe the plaza and need to duck down and get the cover real quick. Moving on into the actual plaza itself. But within in the city of Genesis that is Noatun. Sitting at the bottom of the mountain of Fimbleventer. If I remember the pronunciation of it correctly. Again, it's been fucking forever since I had to touch my functioning copy of Bayonetta 2. So I was forced to use other accurate references. So, when you do reach the plaza of Noatun, you have a couple options as to what you can do from here. So you can snag the plaza pistol, and make a quick run through this little central pool, snag rockets. So you can take as you continue to charge up mid to a temple that makes a red spawn. Even though it may not look like much, we'll get further into that. Into what it's really like in time. Don't you worry. About a thing. Cause every little thing is gonna be alright. Okay, so your other two options are, or you can make a hard left towards the saw in the residential full region. And snag either a plasmanade or a brute plasma rifle on your way over, or to the saw. A little something to help you out if you do find yourself in need of a weapon as you're making a break for another weapon. And now let's actually check out over here. In what I can assume is some kind of religious building. Or at least this was some kind of religious building in the original. But here it houses a spawn full, or a sniper rifle. Well, outside on a conveniently placed balcony, which overlooks pretty much the entire fucking map. Like, if you got control over this one beacon, over this one balcony, you pretty much got control over the whole goddamn map. Pretty much. Well, let's actually have a look at what there is to see on the ground or at least leading up into this temple structure here. As taking the staircase up to the balcony that houses sniper spawn, and you could snag two plasma nades and a spawn for a suppressor. This is the only one on the map, so use it well. This is the only one you're going to get. And this is the only place you can get it. Granted, has a good little bit of ammo, to boot. But, you know. Anywho, as we come outside of this religious building, then we can find a spawn for her Covenant Carbine. And there's another one located opposite it with two extra plasma grenades. But wait, what if we go down here and make a hard left? We find ourselves an energy store. Likewise, when you do so on the left side of the map, right side if you're red, make a hard right, or just simply drop down, we find ourselves a spawn for a Hydra launcher with only 6 spare rockets in it as compared to the standard 12 spare that I do normally get. This is because there lies another Hydra and sword on this map. That's right, there's two of these things. Let me show you where real quick. Okay, so you know, remember me mentioning the temple that houses Red Spawn? Well, on either side, next to the gates here, heard these giant gate structures, you can find respective spawns for your Hydra, a launcher, and energy sword respectively. Except in this case, they're swapped. So, well, as you like going into the plaza, this would be a place where you can get energy sword, this for Hydra. When you're already at the temple, this is where you can get sword, and over here is Hydra. Hope that it's not too confusing. Keyword, hope. Oh, I almost forgot to mention, and the light rifle that you could find on the exact same building as the energy sword. Or no, wait, not as the energy sword, as the sniper rifle back there, and the other suppressor, her back over on the stick. Okay, he's like right over here. Along the balcony that you can get the sniper over there. It turns out if you go like right here, you can find a cleverly tucked away light rifle. Another good little secret armament that they can find if you're in need of a good weapon. It always pays to explore for the map. Actually get to know what there is to see. Okay. Now that we got that out of the way, let's actually have a look at what the temple that makes up Red Base has to offer. On the surface, water pun intended, it don't look like much. That's aside from the standard objective hip spawns, as well as the standard spawn for SMG. But what if I told you, and you people that had actually played the version of this in the actual game probably already know this, but the temple has an underwater entrance. That's right, you got not this whole little area that you could explore. To an extent. And if we go through here, we find ourselves in a secret underwater hallway. That further expands on the secret that is the secret underwater entrance to the temple. Along with a BR spawn, and then two frags. Which of course makes up Red Spawn. My original plan was to build on more from here, but when I noticed my object limit was cutting it close, that's because you have a set object limit to how much shit you can have on the map. I figured we'd just cut it off at this particular end of the underwater or secret hallway. Okay, as the players on Red run out from this particular point, and then have this make up Red Spawn. And likewise, as we have the docks that you initially spawn in the beginning of the level in the original game, or more or less at these two ends of it, it'd be the spawn for her blue team. Anywho, that being said, I guess about that's it for my showcase of my remake of a level straight out of Bayonetta 2, Noatun, the City of Genesis. If you want to download this map for any reason whatsoever, then instructions to do so will be conveniently listed in the description below for your convenience. Conveniently. As usual, if you haven't liked this video, then prove it. Drop a like. If this happens to be the first video on my channel you're seeing, be sure to subscribe to the channel so you always be aware of when new videos, like this one, get released. Provided your channel notifications are on. Don't social bell bell. That means that we hit that subscribe button, and then BOOM! Now you get your notification. Not only will it help me as a YouTuber, but you'll be happy as did. Also, if you know someone else that might like this video as much as you did, then yeah, why not share with them through the newly placed share button down below? I mean, it does exist for a reason. Anywho, until next time, this is Raccoon95, signing off. Peace and out.